In the previous video, we looked at reflection of waves at certain boundary. Like you can see here, some bounce up, but others transmit. Now we're going to look at the second part of what happens to wave when they go through a medium. Also known absorption, also known as absorption, or maybe a term you're more familiar with from X-rays, if you've learned that chapter, attenuation. What happens when a wave goes through a medium? So, as an ultrasound go through a medium, bone, muscle, air, anything, it loses energy. The whole idea is loses energy. And this is a throwback to your idea of damping from oscillation chapter, D-A-M-P-I-N-G. Loss of energy, of amplitude, oscillation, and things like that. I'm going to write that here. Damping. Okay, there we go. This is known as, in this case, application question of wave. We call them attenuation. Attenuation. So in past year, they will ask you to define attenuation. Make sure you are able to say what is attenuation. So I'm going to write that here. Attenuation, a reminder, the defined as the loss of intensity or amplitude, also known as damping, or power of a wave. This happens in ultrasound, happens in X-ray, happens in all kinds of waves. Loss of energy, damping, aka damping. Okay, so what happens inside a medium? Intensity and the energy, where did it go? Lost to where? We know there's a loss, but where does it go? Oh, so it is absorbed by the medium. The medium is like, wow, I got a lot of energy. Come, I take some. Absorb. So then the medium will then heat up. Or we can say the medium heats up. Alright, that's the whole idea of attenuation. Loss of energy, lost to where? Absorbed by medium. So this is one picture representation of how you can think of attenuation or absorption. So if you have an incoming wave, that's on the left side. Incoming. But then you see the amplitude start to get smaller and smaller. So you see this? This is what we call, where have we seen this pattern? Getting smaller and smaller. It looks like an exponential decay. So that is referring to this part here. As you travel a certain distance in the medium, this box we call a medium. Okay, you're traveling a certain distance, you get smaller and smaller. By the time you reach this pink color section, your wave is like really small already. Amplitude is very small. Okay, so that's the idea of attenuation in here. Now, I know we are looking at longitudinal wave. So the means longitudinal wave can go up and down, man. That is a graph representation. If you want the longitudinal representation, this is how it will look like. Lo. From very deep, strong energy, become very faded, very weak. No amplitude. But I'm not going to draw this one on top. I'm going to draw this one down here. So let's look at how we can think of this equation and how to calculate the loss of this energy. So for parallel beam of ultrasound, the absorption of energy is exponential. Ooh, what does that mean? Here I have a piece of something of a certain medium. So let's say a chunk of muscle right here, just floating on a petri dish inside a microscope. I don't know. I'm just putting this here. Okay, so this is a certain medium. Now I'm going to send in my incident intensity. So I'm going to call this I naught sent into this medium. Okay, so what happens is, when I'm outside in this first medium, maybe air, for example, I have a certain acoustic impedance. But when I'm inside the medium, I have another acoustic impedance, Z2. Inside, I have the pink color one is Z2. Outside, white color is Z1. So what happens is, when you send something in, yes, there'll be reflection. We talked about that earlier. So you will have some kind of reflected wave once you hit the boundary. So I'm just going to put this here so we can see that. This is IR. Reflected, but there will be a transmitted portion, correct? So this is going to be called the transmitted wave. Let's say you come until a certain distance and you stop there. Until here. So this one is a certain distance, X. Let's call this until from the beginning until here, X. Okay, this is our transmitted wave. So the moment it enter, this part is IT. After it go through the whole medium and it reach a certain distance, let's call this IT prime, you will have a different intensity already. And there's a graph for it. Let's draw the graph together. Okay, we are ready. So first things first, reminder, I not. Should I label this I not? Actually, no. I not is not necessary because got some reflected. We have to remember that what you send into the medium is broken down into two parts. One is transmitted, one is reflected. So we're going to start with the transmitted intensity at the start, this dot there. So this one actually is IT. You start off there. Then you go a certain distance. Okay, so we have a loss in energy. We go down to here. Okay, and this is called the IT prime. So we have lost some energy by going through the medium, and now we are at IT prime, which is at this point. A certain distance inside. That's what we call an exponential decrease. Okay, you can keep drawing down if you want to do that. And this graph has a certain equation for it. Exponential decrease, right? See the word here, exponential. Exponential decrease. That is going to be a exponential decrease in intensity. The main equation for this will be transmitted intensity, or whatever intensity lah. The general equation is I equals to I naught E negative mu X. That mu looks very familiar. Maybe we have seen it before in X-rays. This is the main equation you will want to remember how to use. So the modern player of this game is the mu, this mu Greek alphabet. This is known as the linear absorption or attenuation. Attenuation coefficient. Aha. And it basically means depending on what medium this is, you will have a different mu that will cause you to lose energy of the wave. For example, if you go to the right, let's see. So there are a bunch of different mu's over here for different kinds of mediums. This is how much each medium absorbs your energy of the wave. So let's see, which one got the biggest? Air got a very big linear absorption attenuation. Okay lah. Why every time air? Can we look at something else? Never mind. What's the lowest one? Water. Oh, interesting. So you have large absorption and you have small absorption. So you lose energy very quickly in air, but you don't really lose energy in water. Really? Like that? You can experiment with this graph to play a little bit more about how this exponential decrease changes. So y equals to E negative mu x mx. So this is how the original graph looks like. Maybe I increase the mu. Let's see what happened to the graph. Zoom, 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 zoom. Whoa, as mu gets bigger, your graph becomes more steep. You decay faster. You go to zero faster. If your mu is very small, goes very far. So if air's mu is very big, means if you send a wave through air very quickly, the intensity will drop down to zero in air. That's just what it means. So I'm going to put a note here in our board. If you have something with a larger mu, you might go down to zero much faster. So this one is larger mu. You lose energy even faster. Your intensity decreases. Remember, these are waves. So you can think of it as, exponential decrease in waves. But you're going to draw the waves in between there like that. Like damping, okay? Damping. Losing energy. Amplitude gets smaller and smaller and smaller. That is the idea of attenuation or absorption. Where the energy go? Absorbed by the metal. Absorbed by this tissue. So, as you lose energy, your tissue or whatever medium here will get heat up. Get hotter. Because the energy from the wave has gone to the medium now. So, that's why we say the medium will heat up. Alright, so that is this whole part on how you can think of attenuation and absorption. Now, before I let y'all go to do examples, here are some level ups we're going to think about. I like level ups. Don't you love level ups? First thing is, you notice we bold the word for parallel beams. What does it mean, a parallel beam of ultrasound? Imagine your transducer is sending in some kind of beam. Okay, this equation is mainly designed for parallel beams, meaning that it's something like this, though. The wave come in parallel. I mean, you can say in the area, something like that. Or you want to draw parallel. How to draw parallel? Ah, like this. Parallel beams of ultrasounds coming in. Non-parallel means you could either have something spreading out, like that. Got some diffraction happening. Oh, we do not like this. Bad. We don't want this generally, but we want this. So that was what it means by parallel beams. Then this equation will work very well for us, and it accurately describes what is happening when the wave goes through a medium. Second thing, Miss, you may say, Miss, what about the reflected wave? What if there's many layers of medium? Body got many layers, what happened? Oh, before we go to the many layers, let me remind you how we calculate the reflected intensity first, the orange color one on the left side. Things are gonna get real fun. Okay, so this reflected intensity, IR, we can calculate it with the reflection coefficient, IR over I, which is also alpha. This will be the difference in the acoustic impedance over the sum of the acoustic impedance squared, everything squared. Okay, remember, this is how we calculate the reflected ratio of reflected intensity. Now we put both together. What if you have a many layer, some reflected, and then some transmitted? What's going to happen? Let me draw the scenario for you. There's a pass here just about this, but it's quite interesting. Okay, let's see this. Let's say we add another layer. There's fat, there's muscle. Oh, yo. Then we send an ultrasound in. What's going to happen? Let's see. So send in some incident intensity, I. When you hit the boundary, what's going to happen? You're going to have some reflection, right? So that's your first reflection. I'm just going to use, for now on, just use dotted. Oh, wow. I'm just going to use dotted line to show reflection. Otherwise, there's going to be way too many lines. So this is the first reflection at the boundary. If there's any lah, okay? And then we have transmitted into fat. Okay, so we go on here into fat. As you are traveling in fat, you will lose some energy. Attenuation happened. Aha. Then you hit the second boundary. What happened? Oh, you got another reflection. So you lose energy due to reflection. Your transmitted wave. Oh, it's another reflection. So I'm going to call this IR2. Oh, I didn't write that. IR1. Second reflected one. A few seconds later, a few milliseconds later. Then the wave is like, okay, some reflected. Never mind, I'll keep going. So then you travel through a muscle for a very long distance. Wow, you're going to lose so much energy in the muscle. You're going to heat up the muscle in the path. This is represented by heat. Okay, so attenuation is happening over here. Losing energy, heating up the fat and muscle. Then finally, you hit a last boundary. Let's say this one is air. Back out to air. From air, fat, muscle, air. Another boundary. Another reflection. So at this last boundary, I'm going to highlight this one. You will have another reflected wave come out. Ding, 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 ding. They reflect back to the source, the transducer. This one I'm going to call this reflected number 3. And then there'll be finally, hopefully, if any left, a little bit of transmitted wave. So the transmitted wave will travel all the way. It will lose energy, but there will be all these points where you hit a boundary, then got some reflected go back. Hit a point and some reflected go back. So I'm going to label this as IT1, IT2, and IT... I guess that was IT3 already lah. Okay, IT3. How to draw a graph for this? Whoa! Okay, let's try. Let's do this experiment and think in our head. You start off inside here. So this is going to be IT1. You enter the fat. As you go through the fat, you lose energy. So maybe it looks something like... Oh, I forgot to draw dotted lines. Give me a second. There we go. Okay, so we lose energy because some attenuation exponential decay happening. Okay, so we go like... Meow. Okay, then we hit a boundary. What happens? You lose some energy due to IR. You reflect back some. So then your transmitter intensity will be a little lower. Now you're going to be going through muscle, so you can... That's a different gradient also. Then at the end, you reflect again, then you lose a bit more, then okay, gone already. So pretty much almost everything is gone. So IT1, and then there's IT2. Wow, why got gap there? Because you lost some energy due to the reflected wave. So your transmitted wave will have broken sections. Then IT3 is somewhere down there. almost zero already. So this is how you can think of intensity of transmitted wave. How about the reflected wave? Okay, I draw all this zigzag, all this thing, means there is an energy loss. Also known as absorption or attenuation of the wave. Because the wave lose energy, give to who? Give to the muscle, give to the fat, so heat loss. So as you are the wave is traveling, you have heat loss. Okay, let's think about the reflected wave, the orange one. What happened? I'm going to try to do an unconventional sketch. Let's look at the first reflection here, inside the fat, right here. As this reflected wave go from this spot all the way out, do you think it's going to have some kind of attenuation here in the fat? Yeah, it's a wave, ma. So it also can have attenuation here. So as you are traveling through fat, you have some energy loss, attenuation. Okay, so this one is, you can say this is a pretty big, you start off here, for example, you have attenuation as you go out. I mean, your wave is traveling this way, lah. The other one is your wave is traveling, your graph, you are going further and further away there. This is in X direction. Okay. And the other one, leh, this very long one. Wow. A lot of things to draw. Okay, so let's draw from the back. Let's work backwards. So as it travels through muscle, it will also heat up the muscle and is also experiencing attenuation due to absorption. So this one, I could just roughly draw something like this. Then as it goes through fat, you have a different rate of energy loss because different medium already, ma. So then this one could be something, I guess another way of drawing that, something like that. Don't worry, they won't ask you to draw this in CIE. This is just help you think about what happens when there are many layers. So you see, I add one layer, suddenly got so many waves already. Okay, so to summarize this video, number one, at a boundary, you have reflection. So I'm going to write this here, reflection at boundary. When you travel through medium, you have attenuation. When you're traveling inside a medium, doesn't matter which wave. As long as a wave travel in medium, got attenuation already. Okay, so remember, reflection at boundary, attenuation in medium. These two things put together or separate, you must be able to solve it. Attenuation in medium, reflection at boundary. So one layer, you want two layer, they won't ask you to draw a graph, don't worry. Two layer, they will ask you to calculate things though, and they'll be, you see that in the higher level examples that we'll post right after this. But that's all for this video. Just the idea of introduction to the idea of attenuation. Just remember, you lose energy as you go through a medium, and you boundary, reflect. So let's go and look at some examples right now to help us understand better this idea of how to use this exponential equation and how to think of waves going through mediums and reflecting at boundaries. That's all for this video. I'll see you in the next one.